Five panelists, five topical issues, no holds barred.
For me, it's not knowledge that's lacking. It's that greed, it's that mentality where you feel you deserve to take your own and take it infinitely and let everybody else just manage however they will manage.
We're almost becoming hardwired to try and cheat. I would, you know, suggest that we begin to hold our leaders accountable.
There was a time in this country when yes. things actually work.
I don't think that any organization should be above the law. And I think one of the challenges we have in this country is about governance across the board.
Well, what I'm saying is that it doesn't really affect us in Nigeria.
I don't know what we can do if the system is already corrupted.
We've been warned as a continent of the influx of the Chinese. If you don't repay your debt, they will just colonize you.
Ours is to provoke the debates, and yours is to sustain it. Welcome to The Advocates. Five guests, five topics, five discussants. Driving home hard facts. Discerned only by the open-minded, not for the faint-hearted. Permit me to lead the pack by asking, what needs to be regulated? Social media or leadership? Aisha Yusufu, the social media activist. Yeah, the same Aisha Yusufu speaks power to leadership in Nigeria by drawing from the American experience. Treasure, our very own first lady, touches on her military involvement with the everyday civilian. I believe that's the way it should be. Evans has a poetic message from Rabbi, and he says, call me a poet. Last but not the least, do I call him now the engineer, accountant, economist? Aung Bolahon is challenging ASU on IPPIS. Utik Balahon no go talk about. I can see you nodding already. I'm shooting straight after the break. I'll be right back.
Five panelists, five topical issues, no holds barred.
For me, it's not knowledge that's lacking. It's that greed, it's that mentality where you feel you deserve to take your own and take it infinitely and let everybody else just manage however they will manage.
We're almost becoming hardwired to try and cheat. I would, you know, suggest that we begin to hold our leaders accountable.
There was a time in this country when yes. things actually work.
I don't think that any organization should be above the law. And I think one of the challenges we have in this country is about governance across the board.
What I'm saying is that it doesn't really affect us in Nigeria.
I don't know what we can do if the system is already corrupted.
We've been warned as a continent of the influx of the Chinese. If you don't repay your debt, they will just colonize you.
When you start every meeting with a prayer, tell lies all through the meetings, and end with another prayer. When former governors turned the Senate to a retirement home and continue to impoverish their people, when the monthly salaries and allowances of a minister, senator or politicians the life salary of a professor, then know that you are in Nigeria, a nation in dire need of regulated leadership. Why it wasn't such a headache to regulate the conventional media with broadcasting rules because of professional ethics, the social media flipped professionalism and made everyone with a smartphone, a broadcaster, reporter, a journalist, which made it easy for lies, half-truth and misinformation to circulate freely. From inception, serious-minded countries have continually set boundaries for the usage of social media within their territories, since they understand the power of information management. But here, we were simply overwhelmed by the wizardry of this new discovery called Twitter, Facebook, and Instagram. To the extent that the PDP government under Goodluck Jonathan and his followers celebrated his Twitter, Facebook account opening, and then government officials followed with a rave. Alhaji Lai Mohammed, as opposition spokesperson, used his platform to push any news, information, and propaganda, including truth, half-truth, and innuendos. Unfortunately, and thank God, now the shoe is on the other foot. And those that benefited from the usage of social media now say the sharing of their previous posts as fake news that must be sanctioned. Oh, my show. I hope this is not hate speech anyway. It is good to regulate every activities of man, social media inclusive, I agree, to avoid abuse, as the end of one man's right is the beginning of the right of another. As even countries like Germany Australia, Russia, and China have such regulations targeted at the social media provider, especially usage of such to promote terrorism, violence, crime, pornography, etc. But unfortunately, our proposed regulation is targeted at the user and not the provider, despite not being able to activate the usage of the existing laws on libel and slander, which are abundant. Maybe it's a result of analog leadership in a digital age, or how you see them. Government should understand that not only social media needs regulation in Nigeria, government attitude to governance needs even stronger and stiffer regulations that must be observed and complied with. A country that spends 33% of its budgets as salaries, pension, gratuity, and travel allowance of public office holders, while 29% aggregate is for capital allocation, should regulate its spending to enhance infrastructural development instead of worrying about social media that's already being regulated by the service provider. States where governors warehouse nodules donated to her people yet promises to give them good infrastructure needs leadership regulation for proactive efforts, effects, and not social media regulation bill. A country ravaged by armed bandits, herdsmen crisis, poverty, kidnapping, rape, fear, villages under siege and Boko Haram, to the extent that army officers are ambushed and killed like chicken, yet when they complain, they are arrested and silenced, need a regulated leadership and social media to consistently expose the ills. A region where militancy is a profession and fraudsters and government are in partnership, where kidnapping, robbery, and killing on our highway is a daily occurrence to the extent that divisional police officers and police commissioners are kidnapped with ease, can only do better with a regulated leadership and not regulated social media. A nation without a sense of history, where leaders insist on leading with their old method and refuse to imbibe and infuse new method and technology, we always think social media it is a problem, whereas it is not. A society where those who took up arms against the state, like militancy, are either granted amnesty or sent abroad to study, like the case of Boko Haram, while sending soldiers on defenseless and innocent youth who are protesting government insensitivity, such a nation needs all the social media they can garner to enhance their collective cries. A problem is good governance and not social media. A sage once said, masking a putrefying sore with a perfumed bandage is the greatest deceit of all. Just give it time. The stench will give truth to the lie. However, we can blame our rulers as long as we want. But unfortunately, they are a reflection and manifestation of the wickedness in us as a people, whether in private or in public. I will therefore advocate, though tribe and tongue may differ, if we stand collectively in brotherhood, we would not see everything from the prism of ethnicity, religion, or tribe, nor mouth the unity of Nigeria only. We would all individually and collectively, with sincerity in our heart, promote that unity, peace, and progress. We will not only celebrate election of Nigerians into various political offices in other countries, but actualize it here. All of this can happen with a regulated leadership and a patriotic followership mindset. Before men may die, but ideas don't. Like diamonds, they always live forever. The ideas we plant today will germinate to make a mar us in future. I choose to regulate myself, and I hope the government do too.
Oh, wow.
Yeah, but why we regulate ourselves as individuals, I will also advocate that in line with your submission that the government should regulate medical tourism. The government should regulate embezzlement. They should regulate all the vices that we have seen so far in this society that has made us not to grow from where we have been all the way. I mean, 60 years of inconsistency, of backwardness and retrogression is one that is so worrisome and is so bad. We're in 2020 and we have not been able to lay hold to what good governance is. In my 40s, I'm 40 now, I don't know what good governance means. I am scared what my son would turn out to be in this society if in 40 years of my existence, I do not know what good governance is.
I mean, you lawyers can correct me. As far as the social media bill is concerned, two things pop up in my head. One, public incitement, and two, the issue of you defame my character and stuff. To the best of my understanding, we have existing pronouncement in the statute of this land that speak to those two issues. Do we?
Yes, we do.
Of course.
So what is this thing then that will make 21 governors and all the traditional rulers to gather in a particular place to come and talk about the same thing? And these are people coming from regions where banditry are taking over, where insurgency is on the other side, and they think
kidnapping
that is more important at this time when there are statutes already that address the main concern of this thing. It goes back to leadership, honestly.
You know, just this morning I was telling a friend, because I saw what he wrote in one of the magazines, Tell magazine, and I said, you know, it's so funny. When Minister Lai Mohammed was opposition spokesperson, there was nothing he didn't say.
Yeah.
He used the same social media. He used the same media that he's finding today. So now he's there, and he now wants to regulate. He wants to bar people from talking. What if, let's reverse it. If it were him, when he did this to Jonathan Ko.
Aisha.
Yes. I really don't know what to say. I just took my mind back to the inaugural speech of the president in December, in 2015, May 29th, his first inaugural speech, and where he actually thanked the social media for the role that they played. And today, they think that APC being in office think that they are going to clamp down on social media. There are laws already out there for if anybody is malign or anything, they can go to the court for that. But what they want actually is for voices not to be heard, for the killings that are happening in Nigeria, for it not to be heard, for the fact that there was a massacre at Lekki toll gate. If there was no social media, as far as they're concerned, and nobody would have known about it, they would sweep everything under the carpet. But I think, one of the things that it's so sad about being a Nigerian is that it's actually a crime to be a law-abiding citizen in Nigeria.
Exactly.
I just saw the report where they talked about bandits who were in the, I think, Katsina State Government House, and they have bought some weapons, and they are being feted and being celebrated. Meanwhile, just peaceful protesters who went out to protest were killed in this country, and the focus is on social media rather than on the fact that Nigerians are being killed every day. Nigerians were being killed under the cover of darkness. They came out in broad daylight, and they were also killed. We need to think about that.
Well, it's sad. I think, really, our leaders need to wake up to press the button on where the problem is, because definitely the problem is not social media. Aisha is next after the break.